This video is going to be about the vampires of Blade, their abilities, hierarchy, different kinds of vampires, and some other things. If you guys have any suggestions of videos about the Blade series, or any other series, then please leave them in the comments below as I always read the comments, and they help me know what you guys want to see. Blade, also known as Eric Brooks, is the main character of the film. His character originated from a Marvel comic. He is a half-vampire due to his mother being bit while pregnant with him. A half-vampire is also sometimes referred to as a Dampier. Dr. Karen Jensen from the first film was trying to develop a cure for vampirism after being bit. She discovered something else instead though. When using the anticoagulant called EDTA on vampire blood, because of their genetic deficiency, it causes them to literally explode. She did eventually find a cure for vampirism, and it was called the retrovirus serum. Hannibal King, played by Ryan Reynolds from the third film, tells us that he used to be a vampire and was cured by the Night Stalkers. He is the only person other than Dr. Karen Jensen from the first film that we see cured of vampirism. But she tells Blade that if he takes the serum, he could die because unlike most, he was born with the vampire virus, making it part of him. So this means that purebloods might also be unable to take the cure because their bodies have adapted to the vampirism differently than someone who is merely turned. He is the only half-vampire seen in the series, and because of that he has some unique abilities, most importantly being a daywalker. He's one of the only vampires to ever be able to walk in the sunlight. One thing unique to the half-vampire is that although he enjoys almost all the benefits to vampirism with minimal drawbacks, he does still, however, age like a human at a normal rate, unlike vampires that live for centuries or possibly thousands of years. All vampires are plagued by the thirst, an inescapable need to consume human blood at any cost. Blade resents being like the same things he hunts, so to stave off the thirst, his friend slash father figure Whistler develops a serum that Blade injects to keep him as human as possible. These treatments, however, cause him immense pain, making him groan and convulse. The vampires in the Blade series rely on consuming blood in order to heal themselves, so Blade also needs this serum to heal because he does not consume blood on a regular basis. The vampires of the Blade series have a lot of the same strengths and weaknesses as most vampires from other series. They are weak to stakes through the heart, silver, sunlight, and are described in these movies as having a severe allergic reaction to garlic. Garlic is also seen being used to prolong the change into a vampire by injecting it. The garlic seems to have a reaction with the infected blood and also the bite area itself, causing burning and some smoke. These vampires, however, are not weak to holy water or crosses like traditional vampires. Though vampirism spreads like a virus, the virus in this movie is indeed rooted in supernatural origins. In this universe, being a vampire grants extremely long life, super strength and speed, as well as extreme resilience. In the first movie, we see a vampire staked to the wall by Blade and set on fire, and is seemingly dead but regains consciousness in the hospital and feeds on a doctor, and the next time we see him, he's almost fully recovered. Blade also later cuts off this same vampire's hand, and when we see him later, his hand is actually grown back. While slightly disformed, apparently these vampires can actually grow back parts of their body if dismembered. They also seem to have some kind of governing body that rules over the vampire nation. They are ruled by a number of houses. Vampires seem well established in large companies and government positions. After a girl is bitten in the first movie, but is temporarily cured with the garlic injection, she insists that she wants to go to the police, but Whistler states the vampires own the police. The vampires actually have a secret treaty with humans, which explains how vampires are able to infiltrate so many parts of government and police. We also see some police officers that are familiars, and familiars are basically human servants for the vampires. By controlling the police and parts of the government, the vampires can stay concealed by killing anyone that gets exposed to their kind, as well as being able to cover up any killings and any other law breaking by the vampires. Any human that is exposed to the vampire society in any way will quickly be hunted down and killed as to protect their secrecy. The vampires have human servants known as familiars. They do tasks for their vampire master, and in return they can be turned into a vampire. Familiars are also marked with a special tattoo of a glyph, specific to their master. This is tattooed somewhere on their body so that other vampires know not to turn or feed on them, or they'll have to answer to their master for disrespecting them. Vampires also use markings on their safe houses as to show other vampires where they are.
Krat pruciribus istampol prota luciano frost. Yachdus pulilipo. Ochach planica dora sarasto.
Ma bocciacci matia olan paurastu prakaritsa.
Vampires possess their own language, which many vampires speak. It is unclear if the language is learned or passed down through some sort of genetic memory. The language also has its own writing system, referred to as vampire glyphs, which are often used as graffiti to mark vampire hideouts. The vampire language contains guttural sounds which are physically impossible for humans to perfectly reproduce. They can push their vocal cords in ways that would permanently damage a human. It is possible for humans to speak vampire language, but the inability to match the deeper pronunciation of certain words means that a human cannot pass off as a vampire to a real vampire. Although a vampire can discern humans purely by smell in person. In the first Blade film, UCLA linguistics professor Victoria Fromkin was hired to design a vampire language. Unfortunately, Pearson died between the first and second Blade movies, and any notes she had on the vampire language were lost. A new linguist was brought onto the second film, J. Matthew Pearson, who strove to match as much as possible from what Fromkin had already developed for the first movie. Only two scenes actually contained constructed language, when a vampire elder berates Frost and when Pearl yells about the Blood God. All other scenes were just intermixed Russian or Czech. There are also vampire elders and an established hierarchy. The first house we see appears in the film Blade, and it is the house that the antagonizing vampires belong to. It is ruled by a shadow council of 12 pure bloods. It also treasures and worships the Book of Erebus, a vampire Bible. The house takes its name from Erebus, the ancient Greek god of darkness and shadow, possibly the original creator of the vampire race, aside from Drake. In the first movie, Deacon Frost is confronted by the vampire leaders for jeopardizing the discovery of their kind by running multiple nightclubs in the city, including the famous Club Blood, where the blood rains on the dance floor from the fire sprinklers. So lower vampires, if they're risking the exposure of the vampire kind, will have to answer to higher-ups in the house. Blood purity in the house is also very important, like most vampire series. One of the vampire leaders states that all the members of this house were born vampires, while he was merely turned, making born vampires of a higher status. One of the members of the Shadow Council also states that they have lived in secret for thousands of years, so this vampire species is quite old. Not sure if they specifically have lived for thousands of years, or is including previous members of their house, although there is members that have lived for possibly a thousand or thousands of years. In the first film, the House of Erebus also seems to have some kind of official historian and record keeper named Pearl. He is in charge of keeping records of all of vampire history, including glyphs and ancient artifacts that they find. We also see glyphs going across his computer screens, so he could have been possibly trying to decipher or translate some of these old vampire glyphs. All the members leading this house of vampires seen in the first film are killed by Deacon Frost while he's conducting the vampire ritual to summon Lamagra. It seems the truth of the stories about Lamagra were lost over time, and the new leader of the house seemed to disregard the Blood God as merely a legend and not real. Lamagra is an immensely powerful and ancient Blood God, the patron deity of vampires, and an important figure in vampire lore as he created Drake, the first vampire. Lamagra can only be summoned through a specific ritual that requires the blood of a Daywalker. This is why Blade had to be used for the ritual in the movie. After being summoned, Lamagra uses the body of Deacon Frost as his avatar until the latter was killed by Blade. The ritual to summon Lamagra is done by sacrificing 12 purebloods, although only 11 actually get used in the movie, as one of them gets killed before the ritual begins. This possibly could have contributed to the reason why Blade was able to defeat Lamagra, because he could have possibly been weakened, having only 11 instead of 12 purebloods sacrificed. The purebloods are then stationed at specific locations in a room and are struck by lightning and seemingly shed their skin to reveal winged skeletons. The Daywalker is drained of blood using a special chamber on top of the temple. When a single drop of the Daywalker's blood touched Frost's forehead, Frost's eyes turned completely red and was soon possessed by Lamagra. Afterwards, a vampire calls for Frost, to which he replied in a whisper, "Not anymore." Blade cannot kill Lamagra by normal means because he or it is seemingly able to heal any wound. Ultimately, he ends up defeating Lamagra with vials of the EDTA, which seemed to be the only weakness that the Blood God had. One very old vampire we see in the movie series is Eli Demaskinos. He's a vampire overlord who appears in Blade 2. He is a pureblood vampire elder of Greek descent and leader of the Shadow Cabinet in Prague. He is centuries old and claims to have fathered thousands of children. Eli has a very frail posture in the movies, which may be a sign that he's become very weakened in his old age. The entire time seen in these movies, he does not display any feat of super strength or speed, once even limping as he fled to a helicopter. It is possible that his advanced age has robbed him of his strength in the same way that an elderly human would be robbed of their strength. So this is a good indicator that although the vampires from Blade age very slow, they do in fact still age and will probably eventually die. So these vampires aren't like some vampires from other series that could possibly live forever as long as they're not killed by another person. And as stated before, Lamagra created Drake. Drake was the original and most powerful of the vampire species. His kind of sought him out in the hope that he will restore vampires to Daywalkers and kill the only Daywalker other than himself, Blade. However, after Blade allied himself with the Nightstalkers, Drake was eventually defeated. Drake was the progenitor of the vampire race, Hominis Nocturna. He terrorized humankind from the first moments of its history, spreading his cursed blood all over the world. According to legend, he was born around the 4th or 5th millennium BC in the cradle of civilization of ancient Sumer, Mesopotamia. He was worshipped by the Babylonians as Dagon, and as the centuries passed, he eventually became known as Dracula. Dracula later became disgusted with the world and retreated to a tomb in Iraq to sleep through the coming ages. Searching for help in their fight with the vampire hunter Blade, Danica Talos and Asher Talos found Drake's 4,000-year-old tomb in the Syrian desert and awakened him. After consuming dozens of humans in order to regain his strength and powers, Drake was informed by Danica on the situation of the vampire's kind and Blade. He was disgusted by their weakness and decided to hunt down and kill the Daywalker. Drake is also seen being able to shapeshift and take the form of other people. He's also completely immune to regular attacks, and the only way he can be killed is with the Daystar virus, a biological weapon created to kill all vampires once mixed with Drake's blood. Drake has a human form, but he also possesses a form resembling a towering demon whose powers were far superior to Blade's. As far as his strength goes, Dracula is the first of his kind. His blood is the most potent of all vampires because he is the progenitor of the species, kind of like Alexander Corvinus from the Underworld series. His blood is pure, free from centuries worth of selective mutation. Hannibal King described him as like a great white shark, as he has never needed to evolve due to him being born a perfect vampire specimen, his only genetic successor being, at least according to Drake himself, Blade. Like all vampires, Dracula is biologically immortal, immune to all disease and aging. Dracula is the oldest vampire recorded, having lived over 6,000 years. Dracula can also run and move at speeds that are far beyond the natural physical limits of not only the finest humans, but also many vampires as well. His reflexes are such that he was able to grab a fast-moving arrow shot at the back of his head, at the same time while being engaged in hand-to-hand combat with Blade. Dracula can alter his form at the musculoskeletal level and can take on the appearance of a different person. He's able to alter his height, the color of his eyes, hair, and skin, and even change the appearance of his clothing. His true form, however, is a towering demon-like being with red skin and spikes on his body. He's able to maintain any transformed state indefinitely though, even for a period of time after death. In Drake's true form, he is seen having a similar mouth to the Reaper species of vampire seen in the second Blade films. Although Dracula is not harmed by sunlight, it's unknown if he's also resistant to EDTA, garlic, or silver. And although Drake is over 6,000 years old, he seems to have absolutely no signs of being weakened, like the other vampire elder we see, Eli, which seems very weakened and is definitely not as old as Drake. Another species of vampire we see in the Blade films are the Reapers. Reapers were a deadlier breed of vampires. Eli Demaskinos, an ancient vampire elder, created this breed in a quest to eliminate the weaknesses of the vampire race via genetic sequencing of his own pureblood DNA. Carriers of the Reaper strain were known as Reapers. While the strain did improve some vampire strengths and even remove some of their traditional weaknesses, it was deemed a failure because it drove its carriers' bloodthirst well beyond that of a normal vampire, making them almost feral monsters. Their heightened metabolism prompted them to feed every couple of hours or else they'd start feeding on themselves. So regular vampires might need to feed once a day or possibly only even up to once a week, but Reapers have to feed every couple hours because their increased metabolism, which gives them their increased strength, makes them need an almost constant supply of blood. Some differences between a traditional vampire and the Reaper vampire is that they have a thick case of bone over their heart in the front and back, making it almost nearly impossible to be staked. They also possess a three-way jaw, in which two sides of the lower jaw split apart at the chin, kind of like the Arbiter from Halo, and the left and right sides of the lower jaw have fangs that inject a neurotoxin to paralyze their victim while they're feeding. The jaw is easily concealed, allowing the Reaper to surprise the victim. Their mouth also contains a toothed inner proboscis. This does the actual blood sucking when the Reaper's three-way jaw splits apart, and is what also transmits the Reaper strain into the victim. Also in the movie, it's mentioned that the Reaper's mouth has very overdeveloped muscles which allow for a much stronger bite. Another difference is the Reapers are not only able to feed on humans, but they're also able to feed on normal vampires. They have an even greater strength and durability than normal vampires. Standard vampires will at least be stunned if shot by standard, non-silver bullets, but the Reapers practically shrug off automatic weapons. They have a complete and total resistance to silver and garlic. They have an improved resistance to EDTA. While normal vampires literally explode into a cloud of blood after several seconds if they are exposed or injected to EDTA, Nomak was only briefly stunned and in moderate pain before shrugging it off with no long-term damage. The only Reaper weaknesses are to sunlight and ultraviolet light, which causes them to combust almost instantaneously. And there's also a constant pain caused by the virus, which can only be satisfied by feeding daily. Impaling a Reaper through the heart is possible, but difficult due to their extra layer of hardened bone over the heart. Because the heart is protected in the front and back by bone plate armor, it is necessary to impale a Reaper from the side. It's also important to note that Nomak was kind of an exception to the Reapers, because all other Reapers aside from him were so dependent on fresh blood that their bodies will start to consume themselves if they're unable to feed for only a couple of hours. It's also shown that their bodies will still try to feed even after their brains are dead. In Blade Trinity, we also see dog vampires. Asher Tallow states that they have been experimenting putting the vampire genes into animals. So in this series, vampirism could be passed on to other species, not just human. I also just wanted to mention that in a deleted alternate cut ending scene in an unknown casino, it's shown that right after the end of the scene, this werewolf creature was preparing to attack the Night Stalkers, Hannibal King and Abigail Whistler. So it kind of looks like they were planning to include werewolves into the Blade series. And if we had ever got another movie in the Blade series, it probably would have included werewolves and lycans. So that's the different species, the hierarchy, and some different things about the vampires of the Blade franchise. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, please leave a like and subscribe if you haven't. I really appreciate it. And like I said, if there's any other videos you guys want to see about the Blade series, please leave them in the comments and I'll read through them. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.